Hello, I'm the teacher in this village.
And I'm the Anganwadi worker in this village.
Have you ever wondered why children in our village often appear sick or tired?
There could be a reason for this that we are not able to see with our naked eyes. Come, let us find out for ourselves.
Good morning. Why are you going to school alone today? Where is your friend Swati?
Swati is sick today and can't come to school. She's often sick these days.
Oh, what might be the reason for her falling sick all the time?
Come, let's visit her house to find out. Oh no, look at Raju. He seems to be eating food with dirty hands.
Welcome. Please come inside. Swati has a bad stomachache and could not go to school today. Raju and Swati seem to fall ill very often these days.
Tell me something. Did Raju wash his hands before eating food just now?
No.
Do Raju and Swati defecate in the open?
Yes. Like all the children in the village, they also defecate in open.
And they must also be playing outside bare feet. It is possible that Raju and Swati are always sick because they have worms in their intestines.
What are worms? And how can there be worms in their intestines?
We will tell you how this happens. First, let us find out what worms are and how they can get inside children's intestine. Worms are organisms that thrive by taking nutrition from the human intestine. Three types of worms are most commonly found in children: roundworm, whipworm, hookworm. These worms spread due to poor hygiene and sanitation. An infected child contaminates soil with feces containing worm eggs. These eggs develop into larvae in the soil. Other children are infected by eggs ingested through food or dirty hands, or by larvae penetrating the skin. In an infected child, eggs and larvae develop into adult worms, which produce eggs.
I did not know that worms can spread so easily. How does worm infection affect children?
Now that we know what worms are and how they spread, let's look at how they can harm children. Due to worm infection, children often fall sick and are unable to concentrate in school. Worms can cause symptoms like diarrhea and weakness, because of which they are unable to attend school or Anganwadi. Deworming children to keep them safe from worms is easy, and there are many benefits to deworming. It controls anemia, improves nutritional uptake, helps improve concentration, capacity to learn, and attendance at school or Anganwadi. It helps reduce worms in the environment, resulting in lesser worm infection in the community.
So, can you see now how worms spread easily and can harm children?
If we are not careful, worms can impact the entire community.
But how can Raju and Swati be treated of worms?
To treat children of worm infection, the government has planned the National Deworming Day.
On National Deworming Day, all children will be given albendazole tablet free of cost in schools and Anganwadi. Albendazole helps control worm infection. Children aged between 1 to 5 years and children who are out of school will be given the deworming tablet at Anganwadis by the Anganwadi worker. Children aged between 6 to 19 years will be given this tablet at schools by the teacher. Children who could not be dewormed on National Deworming Day because of sickness or absenteeism will be dewormed on Mop-Up Day. In addition to deworming, there are some other practices we should keep in mind to reduce worm infections. Keep your surroundings clean. Wear shoes. Do not defecate in open. Always use a toilet. Wash your hands with soap, especially before eating and after using the toilet. Wash fruits and vegetables with clean water. Keep food covered. Always drink clean water. Keep your nails clean and short.
Now we know how we can keep our children healthy by keeping them safe from worms. Come, let us go see how Raju and Swati are doing after they got dewormed.
On National Deworming Day, Raju and Swati had a deworming tablet. Now Raju and Swati feel healthy and also tell their friends about the importance of deworming.
It is our responsibility to keep children free from worms. Worm-free children are healthy children.